everyone. Welcome to Tantra Tuesday. Wow, I'm still so excited to be doing these again after a long break. And today I'm going to do something a little different. Wild Harvest Joe, how fitting that you're here, because today's video is inspired by this book. So today I'm going to speak with you just a little about making love with existence and what Tantra is. And then I'm actually going to do a little reading and share a beautiful piece of a very tantric writing. And I'm going to do a little sound check right now. If you can just put in the comments, if you can hear this song, this is going to help us for the reading. So let me know how the sound is. And I often get asked, why Tantra? Why have I become so obsessed with Tantra? And I think for me, there's so many different spiritual practices and different philosophies and sciences and ways at looking at the world. And so many of them, whether they're, you know, all the way over to atheism or to really even devotional practices like Christianity in some forms. Thanks for the sound feedback, guys. Appreciate it. So the kind of common thread that I found in a lot of these is they can be very mechanistic and very hierarchical. It can really create a almost like a problem-solution relationship with spirituality, like this economy of low resource of being able to connect to spirit. And then there needs to be somebody there who can connect us to spirit, and we can only connect to reality, to existence, in very certain circumstances. And most parts of us aren't even welcome there. Most parts of us, we have to repress, ignore, hide, sweep under the carpet to even have that encounter with the sacred. And none of that felt good in my heart. None of that felt right or true to me. When I found Tantra, I found a tradition that honors the relationships between all things, that honors the relationship of the way that we smile, or sometimes smile with our eyes, at the person walking across us, across the street, or past us on the sidewalk. The relationship that we have with our emotions, the relationship that we have with nature. And in this tradition, there's no hierarchy. Some things are not sacred while at the expense of other things being mundane or abominable. Everything is that essence. Everything is that isness, that underlying force field that connects us all, that I'm sure you've tuned into and tapped into. I'm sure you felt it. That is what Tantra says is God. It's just the thing that's always there, the thing you can't fall out of, the thing you can't mess up and piss off, the thing that's always there waiting to be your beloved. And because this is a tradition of relationships, it uses one of the most beautiful relationships of a beloved, of being devoted to your beloved, to represent anything and everything that we do in our lives. That same sweetness, that same tenderness that you bring to someone that you hold in such high regard, that you feel honored to be with, is the same sentiment that can be brought to making dinner, to sweeping the floor, to changing lanes in traffic. That's more of an advanced practice, but it can be done with that same devotional sweetness. And so I love that every moment in the day is an opportunity for lovemaking in this tradition. And it's really up to us whether we walk through life in kind of an autonomic state where all the people around us are kind of furniture in our solipsistic story, or if we choose to form a relationship with each one of those people, with each one of those birds, with each one of those trees that we pass in our day. And for practitioners of Tantra, it's not uncommon to see one of us standing wide-eyed looking at a tree and feeling overcome by the energy that we feel, the connection and the intimacy of that moment. I had a teacher once, and I saw him in the market in India, and he was just stopped looking at a little, what do you call it, a flock of flies, a little buzzing group of flies. And to most people, they would be either inconsequential or maybe mildly irritating, but he was awestruck by the beauty of these flies swarming in unison around and around in this shape. And he inspired me to stop and look as well. And truly, it was beautiful. So we have the tools in our hands to take every moment from this blah or this stress to this excitement, to that same shot of adrenaline that you get when the person that you're attracted to walks into the room. That's here. That's here with everything. And really, it's our choice if we want to start to train ourselves to calibrate our awareness to experience life like that, to see life like that, to the point where people are going to tell you, you know, that can't be real. You can't be feeling this happy by sitting on your couch and staring out the window. But if you felt it, you know. If you tasted it, you know what it tastes like. I'm going to read you now a piece about devotion. Devotion has been a theme in my life lately, something that I'm feeling more and more drawn to, more and more inspired by, and living it out in a householder way, in a basic everyday way, not just a ethereal twice on Sundays kind of way. So the author of this book is Lauren Roche, and this is a kind of really loose interpretation, but beautifully captures the essence of a sacred tantric text, the Vijnana Bhairava Tantra. So let's turn on some music and do a little reading. This is a good time, if you can, to get nice and comfy and relax. And treat this as your little self-care moment where you don't have to do anything. Just let the words absorb into your bones, absorb into your spirit. Be wildly devoted to someone or something. Cherish every perception. At the same time, forget about control. Allow the beloved to be herself and to change. Passion and compassion. Holding and letting go. This ache in your heart is holy. Accept it as the rise of intimacy with life's secret ways. Devotion is the divine streaming through you, from that place in you before time. Love's energy flows through your body, toward a body, and into eternity again. Surrender to this current of devotion and become one with the body of love. I feel so touched as I read that myself. I'm going to read you one more. Holiness permeates everywhere. Senses cannot grasp it. images cannot represent it. It is totally free. Free to appear as form, free to be beyond form. Heart and mind and body in unison. Attend to the unimaginable. In the intercourse of unknowable and known, an awakening will be born within you. As you join with that reality, which you already are. I love reading these over and over and feeling the words. First time, it's about understanding the meaning of the words, and later, just about feeling them. So if there's anything on your mind, I know I've got some people on the line here. If there's anything you wanted to share or ask, there's space for that now. And you can let me know what you want me to talk about next week. I'll be here at the same time, back in schedule. And I am now just going to go and enjoy the juiciness of this space that this book creates. I'm feeling it. I hope that you're feeling it too. All right. I wish you a beautiful night. I'll see you soon.